Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Tech Edu for you. Today we are going to discuss about the JDBC basics, Java database connectivity. Let's get start our content. Actually, what is meant, first we have to know that what is meant by JDBC. JDBC is a Java database connectivity. It's called the programming framework to get the data from the databases, spreadsheets, flat sheets, etc. The standard Java API for the accessing the relational database hides the database specific details from the application. Here, once if you see here, the Java application is here in the client machine, and we have access through the connectivity. We'll connect through this application with the database connectivity by using the property protocol. Here we are using the property protocol. By using this property protocol, we can go with the we can connect between the JDBC and the database server. We have the four driver for connectivity purpose. We'll use the drivers in the JDBC. JDBC has the four drivers. Those are nothing but the type 1, type 2, type 3 and type 4 drivers. Type 1 driver is nothing but the bridge driver. This is the connected between the ODBC driver, JDBC, ODBC driver. When we go with this type 2 driver, it uses the CLI library file, and next to type 3 driver is the middleware driver. It connects with the middleware server, and the final driver, type 4 driver, is the pure driver. These are the types of drivers. By using these four types of drivers, we'll connect through the we'll connect the application program to the application database layers. This is the API, JDBC API. Java application resides here, and the JDBC driver is here. The JDBC API layers are like this. It includes the JDBC driver API, includes the JDBC manager, JDBC network, net driver, JDBC ODBC bridge, ODBC driver. If we want to connect with the MySQL, it uses the MySQL driver. If you want to use with the SQL driver, it uses the SQL drivers, etc. It defines the set of Java interfaces which are implemented by the vendor specific drivers. Nothing but implemented by the vendor specific drivers. And these applications use the set of interfaces for performing the database operations. The majority of the JDBC API is located in Java SQL package. We need to include each and every time, we need to include the java.sql.star. We have to import this API. import java.sql.star. The JDBC, the driver manager, connection, result set, database metadata, result set metadata, prepared statement, callable statement, and these majority types are located in this java.sql.star. In other advanced functionality exists in the javax.sql package itself. It is a data source file, and the class uses is like this: driver manager connects with the driver, driver connects with the statement, statement connects with the result set. In this way we'll use the classes driver manager, driver, connection, statement and result set. By using these classes we'll go with the JDBC. Here is the another this is the JDBC driver which is used for the Oracle database to system database to SYBase, SQL Server, MySQL, etc. And this is the application program. By using the JDBC connectivity, we'll go with the Oracle database to and the SQL Server, MySQL, etc. This database implements the JDBC interface. Every database server has the corresponding JDBC drivers too. You can see the list in the sanjava.com also. This is the database URLs provided for the Oracle, Derby, Pointbase, etc. And you use it to make the connection to the database, contains the server, port, protocol, etc. JDBC sub protocol name, driver, dependent database name, Oracle theme driver, JDBC colon Oracle colon theme colon at the rate mission name colon 1521 dot database name. In this way, we can connect with the Oracle driver, Derby, JDBC colon Derby colon slash less localhost colon 1527 slash sample database, and for point base JDBC colon point base colon server colon localhost slash sample. These are the database URL. Next, we are going to the step by step usage of the JDBC API. First, step by step process. First, we load the database specific driver. First step we are going to do is loading the database specific driver and then connect the object, getting a connection object, and third step get a statement object, fourth one execute the query, fifth one read the results, sixth one read metadata, it's an optional step, and finally the seventh step closes the statement, connection objects, etc. First step, in loading database specific database driver, the manually it loads the database driver and register it with the database manager. Each and every time we need to register the database driver with the database manager. It loads the class file. How it works, class dot for name of database driver, try. We need to place the try catch block because here there exists an exception, database exception, and try this loads an instance of a point based database driver. This driver has to be a class path, and this class dot for name of org dot apache dot derby dot jdbc dot client driver. This is the static method for static method of class. And it closes, try block is closed, and the we are opening the cache block. In cache block, class not found exception. Why? Because we are using class not found exception, it may occur the class not found exception for this class file. So we are going with the in class file, we'll print the class not exception, the object. It prints the class is not found when there is no class, and org.apache.derby.jdbc.clientdriver is the database driver string. Next step, we are going with the getting a connection object. Here in the try block itself, we'll go with the connection object. Connection is equal to driver manager dot get connection of JDBC colon Derby colon slash slash localhost colon 1527 slash sample, and we'll go with the apps over here, and we'll catch the exception, SQL exception. There exists an SQL exception. This is used to create the connection object, creating the object of connection class. This exists to create the object of the connection class. This driver manager class is responsible for selecting the database and creating the database connections. Using this data source is preferred means of getting a connection object. And next we are going with the driver manager, and this connection will go like this. These are the statements we are going to use. Get connection of string URL, string user, string password, throws an exception, that is nothing but the SQL exception. And next, for connection we can use the statements like the statement, create statement, throws SQL exception, void, close, throws the SQL exception, void, set, auto, commit, boolean, b, throws SQL exception, void commit throws SQL exception, void rollback throws SQL exception. For the connection purpose, we'll go with these statements. creating the statements too. And now we create the statement object from the connection object by using this statement. Those are reside in the java.sql.statement. So we need to import the java.sql.star API import file. Here the result set space the execute query of string SQL. It is used to get the result. It is used to execute and query whatever the query we have written in the SQL in the Java program, in the Java application. This can be executed here. Int execute update of string SQL. It creates and then we'll use the statement space statement is equal to connection.create of statement. This is used to create a connection statement object. This the same statement object can be used for many related queries also. Next we are going with the another step, that is nothing but the executing the query or update. From the statement object, two most useful commands are the query of select result set rs is equal to statement dot execute query of select star from some table, customer table. It executes the select query, or else you can use the create table name. It executes the create query, and you can use the select customer ID from the customer table. It executes the select statement and it gives the output as the customer ID. In this way we can go with the query select. And for action command updates, for you can go with the update or delete. For updating or delete, you can use the execute update of update manufacturer table set name equal to some IBM, some XYZ, etc. Where MRF number is equal to some number. We can give the code number. For manufacturer number, for this manufacturer number, we need to update the value set name equal to IBM. For manufacturer number, for this manufacturer number, we are going to set the name as the IBM. This query is execute the update query, and the whatever the output resides in this query can be stored at the I return value. And you can print this value by using the system.out.println of iReturn also. In this way you can go with the executing statements. After executing the statements, you can read the results. You can if necessary you can read the metadata, and then we'll close the statements. For reading the results, you use the result set. Loop through result set, retrieve the information. For that purpose, we need to import the java.sql.result set. And previously, you have used the java.sql.connection, etc. So, now we are using the Boolean next. It gives the Boolean value. And if we want to go with this, any database string, you can get the string also using the int column number, string column number. You can close these strings, etc. You must call the next function for iteration purpose. Once to move it to the first row, it is the iterator initialized to the position before to the first row. Next, the results can be continued here. You can go with the while dot. This is an example while rs dot next. It moves the while. It moves the while couple of times while end. And string of value dot rs dot get string. It starts from the index. This is the 0 to index 0 to. It starts index 0. From index 0, it is the 0 is the first position, and we can get the string index of r dot get string of 1, rs dot get int of 2, rs dot get int of some value. Likewise you can go through the values too. After the results, you can continue with the java.sql.types database data type. After reading the result set metadata and database metadata, these are the optional things. Once you have the result set or the connection objects, you can obtain the metadata about the database or the query. These gives the valuable information about the data that you are retrieving or the data that you are using. This is nothing but the you can get the valuable information about the data after retrieving the database you are using. So we'll go with the result set metadata, RS meta equal to RS dot get metadata. In this way you can collect the metadata. There are approximately 150 methods reside in this metadata class. So we can use the metadata object. For creating the metadata, we'll use these two steps. By using these two steps, we can go with the metadata. Next, this is the sample code example code for creating the metadata. This result set data metadata result set metadata space meta equal to rs dot get metadata. It returns the column count. For returning the column count, int I column count is equal to meta dot get column count. This is used for number of columns. For name of columns, meta dot get column name. For data type of the column, we can use the meta dot get column type. For column display purpose, meta dot get column display. For precision purpose, meta dot get precision. In this way, you can collect the metadata. These are the some of the examples for the result set metadata. In this way, we can use the JDBC APIs. We go with the JDBC drivers and the steps used in the JDBC. That's all for today's topic. Thank you guys for supporting me by subscribing my channel. Thank you so much.